I want to take this opportunity now before I invite the second speaker to invite the brother of Mr. Namdi Kanu, who is going to speak to us and speak to the world right now. I would like to invite him to speak briefly before I come to the next speaker. I really don't know him, but he will, there you are. There he is. That is the brother, the real brother of Namdi Kanu. I have never seen him before. I don't know him. And I'm shocked. Thank you very much, sir. Welcome to this show. Welcome to this summit of an African nature. And therefore, I want to invite you to introduce yourself. I want to thank the people of Biafra, those who have come out to condemn, like I have condemned, the actions of interception. Interception. And the PLO, I think you better, you will come back to tell us. You are a student of law, international law, and the constitutional law. What is this interception? Reduction. Taking people in air, dragging them out of place where they have gone to seek asylum. What, where, who can allow this in the 21st century? Who? Thank you very much. I would like to, thank you, that is him. I think, yes, thank you very much, sir. You are now, the floor is yours. Thank you very much, God bless you. That you can now take the floor.
Thank you very much, sir, for having me here, Dr. Masaka. And before I could make any speech, first of all, I have known you for some time now, not as far back as 2016.
Yes.
When my brother was incarcerated. That was when we established the first contact with you, Punchline TV. I remember vividly. And I have seen the news making around social media about what happened to our leader, who happens to be my brother, Mazen Namdi Kanu, in Kenya, and what people are saying about it. Please. I sincerely apologized on behalf of the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, Mazen Namdi Kanu, and Biafran people to you, because you are not part of what happened. I repeat, you are not part of what happened. Although the kidnapping of my brother took place in Kenya, Nairobi, which virtually everybody is denying today, even including the Kenyan government. But that reminds me of one thing. I don't know why we should allow such a thing to happen. I want to tell His Excellency, the President of Kenya, Uhuru Kenyatta, what his name stands for. Uhuru stands, means freedom. And probably he never knew why such name was given to him. Years back, when the father, his own father, late Jomo Kenyatta, was accused of being a terrorist because he was leading then the organization called Mau Mau. When the colonial masters accused him of killing his own people and even the colonial occupiers then. It is, or it was, Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe, that rounded up group of lawyers, local and international. With then Eastern region money to come to the aid of Jomo Kenyatta and said he will not leave to see him being hurt by anybody. And that same Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe comes from the same place which Mazi Nnamdi came. And for the Kenyan government to allow such a thing to happen, and they are pretending as if they never knew what happened, it's a shame on Kenyan people, because we know that Kenyan people are very peaceful people, very kind and loving people. When he was adopted, my brother Nnamdi Kanu is not a Nigerian and is not a holder of Nigerian passport. He is a British citizen. And let us not misunderstand exactly what happened. Some people might call it kidnap, some people might call it an adoption, some might call it a rearrest. There was nothing like that. This is one of the most heinous crimes any state could commit against a nation. And this is called extraordinary rendition. Then that led me to ask questions about what Kenyan government are doing. I remember about 15 years ago, Ocholan, the PAK leader, was under the Turkish government. Given the same thing, and today, Mekano, a few days ago, who is manning Kenyan borders? Is it foreigners? Or is it not Kenyan that are manning their own borders? This is very, very laughable. They should understand that Nnamdi Kanu is a British citizen, and we are expecting the Kenyan to take the lead. And I know that the British authority, they are doing everything they can within themselves to make sure to get this issue resolved. As we speak now, that Nnamdi Kanu is going under severe torture. He has the medical issues. And the same Nigerian government could not allow Nnamdi Kanu to have access to doctor or to medication. This is what is happening at this minute as we speak. And the question I'm asking is, what is the British government doing? What Nnamdi Kanu is asking for is what every other person asked, including the father of His Excellency, the President Uhuru Kenyatta. That was why your father gave you that name, because he fought for the freedom of the Kenyan people. And selling your own people where they'll be killed. I think this is the worst thing you can do as a Pan-Africanist. We are working to keep Africa free. We are working to make sure that Africa develops the way it's supposed to be. But it's very, very unfortunate that people who we are looking onto are the ones misleading us. And I'm calling on the African community, EU, European Union, United Kingdom, United States of America, to intervene in this case, because this is the worst crime any state could commit against any nation. This is called extraordinary rendition. It is not kidnapping or adoption. For that reason, I wouldn't want to go into more details. But hopefully in the next days to come, people will know exactly what played out. I can categorically say it again. My brother was adopted in Kenya, and I'm calling on Kenyan government to step up to their responsibility and tell the international community what happened at this 21st century. Such things are not allowed anywhere. And once again, I thank you, Dr. David Matenga. Please. Do not be angry on your people. You've worked for Biafra, you are working for Biafra, and you continue to do it. We are not paying you. You are doing the job because of your love for freedom. And don't allow anything to deter you. I apologize again on behalf of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, and the entire Biafrans to you. Please, thank you very much for having me here.
Thank you. Thank you very much, my comrade.
The recording has stopped.
Thank you very much, comrade at arms, comrade in arms in the struggle for the people, the oppressed. I would not, and I have never lost any iota of my blood thinking about working with anybody who oppresses the people of any race, anywhere in the world. In my 36 years in exile, I have supported very many people, including Obasanjo, Chief Abiola, and the other guy who was killed in prison. We supported, we demonstrated with Nigerians, together with the former presiding president of the International Criminal Court, Osuji, in London. We took the London Embassy of Nigeria, surrounded it for several hours, breaking windows in order for the Prime Minister, Ken Sarawa. I stood firm together every Friday from 3 p.m. up to about 8. Every Friday until Abacha released and killed the rest. Abiola was killed. That Obasanjo, you see there walking with his African journeys, is because of my voice. And I feel very hurt when somebody could even think of me. I did not know where Mr. Nnamdi Kanu was. I didn't even know he comes to Kenya. I don't know. But I've been struggling for the people of Biafra for 6 years, voluntarily, and I will continue to do so until he gets fair justice. I'm not going to keep quiet. No. I don't work for the government of Republic of Kenya. The government of Kenya itself, as a Minister of Foreign Affairs and Internal Security, they will find out. Maybe it was done, I don't know, because at least now you have been in touch with the lawyers of Nnamdi Kanu. They have told you exactly the truth. We don't know. I don't know what happened. I was shocked. But of course, you will have Buhari and his henchmen turning propaganda on. You know that interview we did shook Buhari, because we told the world the truth. That interview on 21st of May, my viewers and the listeners and the conference took Mr. Buhari to the bones. Because this time the whole world heard, the British government heard the truth about what is happening in Biafra. So we are enemies. Maybe I'm equally the enemy, the next target, I don't know. That is all I can say. Thank you very much. Thank you, brother. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.